Rhode Island enters the history books once again.
Today, the nation's first offshore wind farm began operations. Block Island Wind Farm is now producing electricity.
It's a story we've been tracking since 2008 when the idea was first brought to light.
Eyewitness News reporter Steve Nielsen joins us now live in studio with more details on today's milestone.
That's right, a historic milestone, not just for Rhode Island, but for the entire United States. The offshore wind farm off the coast of Block Island is the nation's very first. Deepwater Wind announced that the five massive wind turbines began commercial operation today following a successful four-month testing phase. It comes following an installation process that took 2 years, with parts of the turbines being transported across the Atlantic Ocean from Europe. The Block Island Wind Farm is expected to supply 30 megawatts of electricity. That's more than enough to meet the island's current demand of just 3 to 4 megawatts, and all of the excess megawatts of electricity will be redirected to mainland Rhode Island via a submarine cable running between Block Island and Narragansett.
So when we're at fully operational speed, we produce enough energy for about 17,000 homes. And most of that energy will end up on the mainland. So the project is interconnected in South County, in Narragansett. So that's where the energy is flowing right now.
And Rhode Island Senator Sheldon Whitehouse, a staunch environmental advocate and member of the Senate Committee on Environment and Public Works, said this to us: "This is a historic milestone for reducing our nation's dependence on fossil fuels, and I couldn't be more thrilled that it's happening here in the Ocean State." Deepwater Wind says the Block Island Wind Farm was completed on time and on budget. More than 300 local workers helped develop, build, and commission the project. And they tell us their next project is another wind farm 25 miles south of Block Island in federal waters, which they hope to begin construction on in just the next few years. I'm Steve Nielsen, Eyewitness News.